Welcome back to CAD/CAM tutorial. Today we are going to design a simple turnbuckle in SOLIDWORKS. I hope you like it. So let's see how to sketch both the parts and assemble, and at the end we will give this simple animation. I hope you like it. Now here we will make our first part of turnbuckle, eye bolt. So let's start to create. We will choose top plane sketch. Now this is our main plane. Select here line, and I'll start from just above the, then go back this point and it will automatically convert into a circle. Draw a circle, exit. We kept our dimensions in inches, unit in inches. You can see here, you can directly change it from here, inches. Let's choose center point, exit. Now select this end point and this line, and it should be coincide. Okay, let's try some fillet. This fillet actually we want to keep 0.375 inch. Okay, let's try the other dimensions. Let's make this length 1.5 inch, and distance from here to ...1.75 inch. Okay, and let's try this 1.25 inch. It's bigger actually, it's divide by 2. Okay, actually diameter is 1.25 inch. So that's perfect. Now the only thing, balance angle 15 degree. Now see, our geometry is fully defined. So this is the shape of eye bolt. Now let's leave it. Now we need to create a circle at this point. So there are multiple methods. Even you can directly choose from here, but I'll make a plane first. Plane. First I'll choose this line, then this end point. See, a perpendicular plane is created at the end of this point. Let's select OK. Now choose this plane, sketch circle, and draw a circle at this point. See, OK. Even you can directly dimension it, 0.36 inch. That's fine. Exit and go to features, sweep to boss base command. See here the profile selected, just select the path. You can see the shape of eyeball. Everything keep as it is in option, follow path, none. Okay, let's hide this one plane. And choose this part 1 default, go to appearance, and I'll define some material so it looks metal, and I'll choose chrome finish. Oh, let's look at, but go back and let me finish this one, then at the end we will apply material. Choose chamfer. ...0.05 inch. Select this end and this end. Two ends we selected. Okay, that's it. Now here we want to create some eyeball thread. So let's choose this face sketch. Now select this circle, or select this circle, convert entity. Oh, cancel it. convert entities. Now see, a circle is converted. Now it's time to create some paths for thread. So the things are same. Go to curves, helix and spiral. Now see, according to this circle, choose pitch and revolution constant. Here we will choose the pitch, number of pitch, 0.055 pitch. The gap between two threads, it is going reverse direction, so uncheck this box reverse direction. That's it. And revolution 25, it's fine for us. Angle 0 degree counterclockwise, and this one no need taper, helix, anything. Okay, now it's time to create some. You can see this is the end point. So let's check if any plane is going to met. Choose top plane, either it is lying on top plane or not. I think it's lying on top plane, so no need to create any other plane. Just simply select top plane, a sketch. That's it. Now here we will create it. Exit. Now select both the lines, and we need to choose equal. Okay, let's make some angle 60 degree. That's it. Choose fillet, and we want to define some fillet at this corner. Let's define the 0.005 inch. It's a small angle. Select OK. Select here OK. OK. Line. Draw one vertical line. Construction line. For just dimension purpose, nothing else. OK. Now this is the length we need to deploy, 0.032 inch. Okay, now select any center point of this line. Just find out where exactly the midpoint of for this line. Okay, select this midpoint. See here, press shift key and select our path. See, undo the process, and we will do one thing, put a star point there. Exit. Now select this star point and this curves, and here you'll find option make peers. See, geometry is fully defined, so simply exit. And go to feature and select here swept cut. We want to cut a thread inside, so here the profile selected, just select the path. Now you can see the preview. Let's check the preview. Even let's everything keep as it is. It's simply follow the path. Okay, it may take time because thread calculation, it takes little time. Or maybe your PC is a hang, or it's, there are many reasons. I don't know why it takes too time. Come on. Okay, I'll hide this thread. Now look, this is my thread of eye bolt. I'll define some material. Let me choose which. Chrome. Oh wow, this looks nice. Chrome. If I'll go for other satin finish chrome, satin finish chrome also looks gives a real view. No, this gives better look. Polish the steel. It gives a better look. Let's save this one. Save it. Go to desktop. New folder and create a folder. Turn buckle. This is the part one eye bolt. Now let's make the other part, the main body of turnbuckle. Now here let's start the second part of turnbuckle, the main body of turnbuckle, from where we are going to fix our eye bolts. So let's choose front plane, a sketch, start with line and draw one geometry, simple geometry. Exit, make it vertical. Now do one thing, let's define, make some relation equal. Select this two tapered line, also make equal. Select center line and draw a center line, make it sure it is passes through origin and it should be horizontal. Okay, let's first select both the, no, better to make one center vertical line. It is easy for the symmetrical purpose, it should be vertical. Now let's define, select both the end point of this main line and center line, symmetric. Now this geometry is symmetric. Let's define this, keep dimension a unit in inches, 4.09 inch, that's it. Now from here to here 0.14 inch, select this point, this point let's make 0.25 inch, and select this point, this one 0.47 inch, that's it. And define one angle with this 20 degree. Now looks, now the geometry is fully defined, no need to define anything else. Go to feature, choose here revolve boss base, select this bottom line as the axis of revolution. See, keep 360 degree blind. Okay, see, this is the main body we created. Now we want to trim it, so choose same front plane, a sketch, select this outer line, convert entity. Now it is converted. Again choose up to here and convert into some line, exit. Let's define this one, this point from this line 0.4 inch. And here we are going to define some radius, so this radius 0.5 inch. Now here we created radius, but see here is some relation created with this one, so just delete this relation, make sure it is floating mode. Mirror, select these two lines and mirror against this vertical line. Okay, choose the line, connect it. Okay, draw one center line exit. Make this line for construction purpose. Mirror, select the full geometry and choose your mirror against this horizontal line. Okay, the smart dimension, let's define the gap 0.308 inch. okay, now here also let's define some tangent relation. That's it. So it looks, see, the geometry is fully defined. Now you can see many of my viewers asking me how to remove this green line. So it is very easy. You just check here, drop down these view head-ups, and here you'll find one option, view sketch relation unchecked. See, it's unchecked. Even you can go to view, select here hide and show, and at the bottom you will find sketch relations. Select OK. See, it's appear. So it's up to you whether you want to keep or not. So this is the fully defined extruded cut. Keep end condition through all both. Okay, that's it. Now select top plane, a sketch, normal. Now here in center we want to make some hole. Choose here a straight slot, center point is straight slot. Let's define this. Let's make this length 2.485 inch. radius. See, select here extruded cut and select also through all both. We want to cut in both direction. Okay, that's it. Now it's time to make some thread inside. So how we will do it, just select here chamfer 0.05 and select both the ends. Okay, now we will start chamfer from this side. So we want to start from this inside edge. So let's create one plane, choose plane, and here select this inside outer edge. You can see the preview of edge exactly merge on this one. Okay, see, now select this plane one, sketch, and select this inside circle and convert entity. This is what we want to make. Go to feature and select helix and spiral. Here we want to create the thread pitch and revolution. The pitch gap we want to keep same, this 0.055 inch. uncheck this, we want to make inside, and number of revolution 10. Okay, 0 degree and clockwise direction, select okay. Now here we selected, just find out where exactly the end point. This is the end point, and let's check whether this available in any plane or not, because here we want to draw our profile. So better now here at this point we need to create a plane. So what we will choose, we will see any plane available. I think top plane available for this point, so let's choose top plane, a sketch. You can take from here a normal view, see this, or even directly I put command here normal view. That's why I'm able to drag here, choose the line, sometime it's draw a perfect triangle, exit, select both the lines, make relation equal, choose the smart dimension, and define angle 60 degree. And let's choose the height also, 0.04 inch. Okay, now here you will find one center point. Just select this center point. See, it is selected. Press hold shift key and select this spiral, and here you will find make pierce option. Now see, it is pierced. Fill it 0.005 inch. Select this corner. Select yes. Okay, cancel. Now exit and go to feature and select here swift cut. Now it's going to create a thread here. See the path selected, profile selected. Just choose your path. You can see the preview. Select OK. That's it. Just hide this one. Path, hide. That's it. Select section view. OK. Now you can see the threads. Exit. Now it's time to mirror these threads to opposite direction. So let's choose any suitable plane. Right plane, mirror, and drop down this menu and choose directly swift cut. Here choose geometry pattern. Okay, that's it. It's time to add some material. Go to appearance, steel, and I'll choose cast stainless steel. Edit appearance, and I'll add yellow color. Okay, that's it. It looks nice. Let's save this part too. Body. Now let's assemble this one. Turn buckle body. Even actually we want to create some name here, so we can do it. Front plane, plane 0.5 inch. That's perfect. Select this plane, sketch, and choose your center line. Make sure it is horizontal, and make sure you drawn in mid. Keep little down. Here choose text. So the line selected. Now here choose CAD CAM tutorial. You can see. Line, you can just little, actually it's supposed to little bigger, but that's fine. It's use documents font. Okay, keep metallic bold. Inch. Now it's perfect. Okay, now exit and go to here you will find one option. Okay, sorry, wrap command. Now here many options, so we will make emboss. Here we need to choose surface, so I'll choose this surface. See, and here let's make 0.005 inch the embossing depth. Select here source of sketch already selected. Look at this, it is embossed, but still if you are not satisfying, edit, and here 0.02 inch. Okay, now it's quite double. Now select this emboss part and let me define some dark color. Okay, that's it. So this is our turnbuckle body height. Look, cast stainless steel. Let's save this one. Now let's start the assembly. Now here let's start to create the assembly of turnbuckle. New part, assembly. Now this is the SolidWorks assembly window. Here it is asking you begin assembly. Let's start or browse your parts. So I'll choose first part because first part by default always fixed. Open. Actually you forget to do one thing. We need to change dimension, inches, because whatever relation we are going to create, it should be in inches. Let's browse the other part, eye bolt. Okay, now let's rotate this component. Okay, mat, select this face and select this circular edge, and it will create concentric relation. Concentric relation. Okay, drag it out. Keep total, drag it out. Now just go to mechanical mat, screw, revolution per inches. Select this surface and this surface for inches and keep 12 revolution per inch. Keep reverse. Okay, select okay. Now let's fix. Okay, it's going even. We need to create one more relation. Choose mat, go to advanced mat, and here choose distance. You want to make maximum and minimum distance, so select this face and this face, and in between we will create maximum and minimum relation. So here we will define some relations like 1.3 millimeter max and 0 inches, sorry, not millimeter, 0. Okay, now let's try. This is the limit we put it here, so it will not go beyond that. Okay, that's fine, that's the limit, it will not go beyond that. Even you can, let's browse our next part. Not even browse, just press control key, copy this one. Okay, circle and this corner, concentric relation. Okay, take it out. Mechanical mat, screw, select this face and this face. 12 revolution per inches, reverse. Okay, and let's define some advanced mat. Here choose distance. Better let it put inside. So let's put some inside. Actually, see, it's going. Because if you want to create some relation here, you need to show this one beyond this. That's fine. Choose mat. Go to advanced mat. Select this face and this face. Make the maximum limit 1.3 inch, minimum 0 inch. Okay. So this is our main turnbuckle. It is very useful in our day-to-day life. I hope you like it. Yeah, let's try some relation. Okay, let it fixed inside. Okay, let's save this assembly. Keep assembly only. Now we will give some little animation to this. Right click, motion manager, go to motion study, motion analysis. I'll keep always frame higher, so for the smooth animation, that's all. First I'll choose motor. I'll choose this motor reverse direction. And revolution, I'll choose 50 RPM. Okay, now calculate. I think this is the reverse direction. We choose wrong way. Stop it. Right click, edit feature, and here uncheck the reverse direction, and the speed also make little higher, so that 80 revolution per. Okay, now play. Okay, now it's coming out. This is what we want actually. So you will easily see how it works. Many purpose it is going to use in tracking, or it's many purpose. Even in manufacturing industry also, we are going to use turnbuckle to fix any two poles or any two doors or anything like this. Now once we completed this one, we will choose this one. Now again choose motor, this time select this one, ATRPM. Okay, now again calculate. See both coming out together. Now this animation, you can save it by clicking save, and it will again calculate and it will save in your destination. It's simple, and let me complete this one, then I'll show you how to save this animation. Okay, now let's play. See. Even if you like to save, just click here. Choose whatever your file size. Here you will choose name. Choose your desktop destination, frame, and save. And here uncheck and select OK. And your file will be saved in your destination. I hope you like it. Don't forget to share and like our video. And please subscribe our channel for more video and more projects in SolidWorks. Thanks for watching.